Dustin, congratulations on the win. Talk to me about how good that felt, snapping a skid and having the crowd behind you and being able to go out there and put on a performance like that.
Great. It definitely helped having the crowd. I know, I think a little bit more of them were for him originally coming from New York and all, just judging by the cheers at the beginning. But I think I convinced most of them to come over to my side by the end. It's a great fight. Shout out to Dwight. Takes two to tango, and it was a lot of fun. It was just the last couple fights I've had such problems with nerves. I came into this one feeling awful, like physically great, but like about to puke, nervous, and then just walking out, seeing the crowd, and just feeling that energy. It was just like, all right, yeah, this is how that's supposed to be. I almost forgot.
Yeah. Can you think of another time where you've had that much fun in there? Because, like, I think in between the second and third rounds, when you stood up, you kind of even put your hands up. Was that one of the more fun fights of your entire career?
I have not had that much fun in a fight since 2018, so it's been a while. I was really second-guessing my love for the sport coming into this one, and I found that again. I had a great time.
No doubt. And I guess kind of the way that the fight played out, is that what you were kind of expecting, kind of a grueling sort of, you know, three-round fight? It was fun, don't get me wrong, but I just mean, were you surprised at how tough he was at all?
I mean, I'm trying to assume that everyone's super tough now. My last two fights, I got over-anxious on trying to catch that finish in the third round, and I really paid for it. So it definitely was part of the plan to take a step back and stay calm, stay focused, keep to the game plan, and not get too over-anxious. But I did want that finish. Definitely went for it with the ground and pound and was swinging for the fences when I had the chance. But his distancing is hard to deal with. He stays on the outside and pops in then real fast. So it was hard to really get a hold of him the first round, and hard to really land anything flush in the other rounds too, without getting into a dangerous firefight.
And you're from Pennsylvania originally, right? So did you have any family or anything that was from Pennsylvania come out here?
My brother's in my corner. And so I have some family that were able to come up, and it's the first time that they've ever been to one of my professional fights. Most of my fights have been over where I live now in Germany. And since I've been in the UFC, they've all been in Nevada in front of small crowds at the Apex. And it's great. It's great to have that support and to know my family's out there watching, cheering along right here. So I'm looking forward to getting out of here and going to see them.
And how did you end up in Germany again?
I went there for school. I did a year abroad over there, really liked it, moved back for my master's, and stayed ever since.
Awesome. I guess last question, where do you think you go from here?
That depends a lot on the UFC brass. This is my last fight on the contract. I've had, when you look at the whole thing, a pretty lackluster performance in the UFC so far. I think I've definitely shown my potential in a lot of my fights leading up to this. Showed that I can go in there and get the win with this one. So it's time to sit down, talk with them. See what they think about it, and figure it out from there.
Dustin, Jim Greece, MMA Weekly. I just want to ask you about that mindset. You lose three in a row. As a guy, and I'm always fascinated by this, because most fighters who make it here don't lose much on the way here. And then all of a sudden, you're stepping up to the top of the level of the sport, and you're taking those L's. And that mindset, you said you weren't sure if you wanted to continue. For what was it that you thought about in that time, and what was it that kind of got you back going again and wanting to compete at this level?
I think the only thing that was really holding me on was still having my contract. I was pretty convinced I was going to lose my contract after my last fight. That was pretty rough. I didn't expect that the UFC would keep me around, and I'm incredibly grateful that they gave me another chance to show what I can do. It was rough. Going from a 10-fight winning streak, not losing for years, and then going on a 3-fight skid, my first skid ever, was really rough. But then coming into this one, I wasn't expecting to get this fight anyway. So I was able to take a bit of a step back and be like, hey, it's just like the Contender Series again. If you win, you're fighting for that contract. And if you lose, then you're back where you thought you were going to be anyway. So that helped take a little bit of that pressure off and just put it into perspective again. But I'm just grateful that I got that last chance to really show what I can do. And then I went in there and got the win against a tough opponent. So.
And we talked about the crowd already, or you did, but that slam. You know, when you get that chance and you make the most of it the way you did tonight, not only to get the win, but to put on a show, to get the crowd involved the way you did, and to slam them like that, I mean, that's something that'll get you another fight, right?
I hope so. I tend to be a pretty reserved, quiet guy. A little bit of my thespian comes out when I'm in there. I do like to put on a show. I like to feed off that energy that the people have in the crowd. And so, yeah, I know what I am. I'm a prize fighter here to entertain people. So I'm going to go out there and try to make it entertaining. Obviously, I want the win. I'm a competitor, too. But there's definitely got to be a little bit of that showmanship in there, too.
And that feeling you have, last one for me, it's got to be amazing to have had the feelings and been through what you went through to feel the way you feel right now, just at least for no other reason than to go out there and prove that, hey, I belong here and I can get it done here.
Yes. Yeah.
Just expand on that a little bit, the thoughts behind that.
I mean, you said it. I went into my first UFC fight and it was a great matchup. I'm against a good opponent, but someone who I would consider to be a good first opponent for me and Kyle Daukaus, and I was really looking forward to going in there and showing what I can do. I try not to look at comments and things like that too much, but there definitely was a little bit of that. He only won because it was a fluke and the guy broke his arm in the Contender Series. And so I was really looking forward to going in there and showing, no, I can fight. And then I got that long COVID and just looked bad. I just fought really poorly. And now I put even more pressure on myself for the next one. I was like, all right, like now everyone thinks that you have no cardio and that you only won on a fluke that one time. So now you really got to go in there and show them what you can do. And it was a tight fight. And then I got over anxious against one of the best grapplers in the world. And obviously that's not a great idea. And then again, the same thing. It's like, hey, there's all these expectations. Dana White was talking me up after the Contender Series. And now I've gone on my first two-fight skid. And I smashed the guy for 2.5 rounds and lost focus at the end and got choked. And it was one of the most devastating things that's ever happened to me. So bouncing back from that, getting this win, getting a good technical win in front of a crowd for the first time is just, it's a huge weight off my shoulders. As I said, it's I definitely lost a bit of the love for the sport. I love training, but this fight has brought it back. I feel great. Want to get back in there again.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Hey, Dustin over here. I'm Will Grant with 77 WABC Sports. Congrats on the win tonight. So we were at the weigh-ins yesterday, and we noticed you had just the coolest mustache. Can you just walk us through why, you know, you decided maybe to cut it right before and, like, how that played into how you fought?
Okay, so the mustache has no bearings on the way I fight. I appreciate that you liked it. I didn't have enough room in my luggage to pack a hair clipper. So being over in Vegas for 3-4 weeks and then here on the East Coast, I went from clean shaven to a full beard, and I didn't really feel like fighting with a full beard. And then my coach Dominic brought his clippers, and they just were doing a very slow job. And so I got tired of it. And so I left the mustache. And then got the rest of the job done later. That's pretty much it.
Hey, Dustin. Mike, 77, WBC as well. Also, let the record show, I was a huge fan of the mustache as well. You said you found a love for the sport again. Congratulations. What's the next thing you do after winning this fight? Do you spend time with your family? You go out to a club? You know, play some sport? What do you do?
Yeah, I'm just meeting up with my family that's come up here, my mom, my sister. I think I got some aunts and uncles and cousins that have come up. Just eat some pizza, drink some beer, go to bed early, and then go back to home. For me, is Germany, and yeah, just relax a little bit. I don't go clubbing. I don't go crazy on partying. I just want to relax with the people I love, and so that's what I'm going to do.
Thank you, man. That was awesome. Just final one question. What's the preferred beer? What are you going to?
I've been living in Germany for 8 years, so a German beer would be best. But if we're stateside, there's cheaper beer and there's better beer, but there's no cheaper, better beer than Yuengling.
Love it. Thank you so much, and congrats.
Thank you.